making us North America's fastest growing auto brand in 2016. Take on 2017 and get the safety you'd expect. The fuel efficiency you need and America's best truck warranty. Get to Nissan's Take On 2017 event for 0% financing for up to 72 months on 11 models or save up to $10,000 on select models.
That is Jordan with TYT Network. So we were talking before, and Governor Snyder, apparently the emergency managers are getting, you know, charged and all these things, but he's still living high in Ann Arbor. Talk to me about, you have places like this where obviously injustice is going on, and the governor's not doing anything, the mayor's not doing anything, and he essentially poisoned this city.
Yeah, my name is Lucia Williams. I'm a Flint resident. I've been here all my life. And just to see our city, our homes, being torn apart, upside down, the governor, you know, made this man-made disaster, and then to joke about it, or having the highest paid legal staff off the backs of taxpayers, you know, is unacceptable. You know, we have the new charges that came out against emergency manager, but we want the governor. We want the governor to actually be charged and brought to justice. And we won't stop until that happens.
As far as I know, the governor spent more money on his legal staff and his public relations firms trying to make people think everything's A-okay here. More so than any relief to actual citizens.
Exactly. And then, you know, it has the audacity to say that they want to stop door-to-door delivery through the wintertime to, you know, a lot of disabled residents, ones who have children and can't get to the water pods. You know, we need that door-to-door delivery for our families. And, you know, just for him to even say that he wants to stop it and how much it costs to happen, you know, and for our mayor to actually agree with that, it was just terrible. You know, it was another stab in our hearts about what's happening here. And we still cannot drink, bathe in our water, you know, and they want us to pay our water bills. And it's actually preposterous. It's, you know, it's actually, like Ms. Linda said, it's no trust no more here. You know, who do you trust? And as far as the government, no.
What I find really crazy is they're talking about, they're sending these shutoff notices saying if you don't pay, you're out. And also they're saying that they're going to take away the tax credit because they had a credit in place for the water. You know, thank you for giving us a credit for the poisonous water, that they're going to take away that credit as well.
Yeah. So, yeah, for these residents out here at Lakeside to receive the turnoff notice from the city saying they're going to shut them off because their landlord failed to pay his portion of the water bill, which we feel like, okay, everyone has to be held accountable as far as the bills and everything, but to actually take it out on the tenants who have been doing the right thing, paying their rent and paying their utilities and, you know, being able to not use the water, it's baffling. It's baffling and it's heartbreaking, and we should not have to pay our water bills. We should only be paying for sewer.
Well, I was about to say, you were talking about, okay, people need to be held accountable for bills, but I'll take it from my man Bernie Sanders. He says, if you don't demand better, you're not going to get better. Right. Why should people be paying for the water, period? You can't drink the water safely. I don't care what they say about filters or anything like that. Let me tell you something. If this happened in New York City, Los Angeles, Ann Arbor, the National Guard would be in 10 minutes, and the water would be fixed in 20 minutes.
It'd be fixed. But it was the rich side of Flint, they do something about it. But because it's low-income people, we're no better than homeless people. You know, we should be able to help ourselves. I worked full-time till I was 42 years old. I mean, what else am I supposed to prove? I did my time. I paid my taxes. I should be able to live on my disability and not have to worry about people robbing me of my money that I worked for. I mean, what's that say about the government? I mean, the president makes money off us. Him and Michelle aren't going to go without when they leave the White House. The governor, when he leaves his home, he's not going to go without. They're well taken care of after they're not in office. You can't tell me they're not. Hillary and Bill Clinton aren't hurting just because she didn't make it. Our biggest fear right now is Trump being president. I didn't vote for the man, and I don't care if I'm saying that on TV. I did not vote for him.
You're saying it on the internet, so even better.
Well, I'm not a Trump fan. Never have been. Yeah, Hillary's a woman, but she's for the people. She's helped kids that didn't have insurance. She helped kids get insurance. She helps low-income families. Trump's out for the rich people and himself. Us low-income people are not going to be able to battle him.
I'll give you the kid part. I don't know if she's for the people, but that's a whole other discussion.
And also just for our president to stop in our city during the middle of the hyping of the water crisis and to drink a glass of water and say, it's okay. That was one of our biggest letdowns that we had in this whole thing, because he came in, when we seen him come in, it was like a sense of hope. You know, here comes the National Guard. Here comes the troops that we needed. You know, he's the one going to hold Governor Snyder really accountable. We got the power now, and it didn't happen that way.
You mean the filtered water that he drank?
Yeah, the filtered water. And it made us feel like we're out here on our own. It's like a third world country here. When you go around Flint and you see just the water pods and you see how families are using 5 to 8 cases to take baths, you know, even with me taking baths, you know, and some families are just taking baths in the water hoping that they don't get a rash, you know, that's almost like having unprotected sex, you know, just hoping something doesn't happen. And it's scary, and we shouldn't have to live like that, you know. We thought we were going to get more water pipes through the summer. We actually have 499 replaced. You know, it's 1,000 more to go. You know, money, where's the money? Is a lot of money came in through donations. You know, where's the money at? There is no good tracking accountability to where the money was going.
Is the 499 pipes replaced actually in homes? Because I've been told that that number is a little inflated.
It could be. You know,
And that's, by the way, 499 out of what, like 45,000?
It's a lot. So we,
and that's part of the fast track program, they call it.
Yes, that's the fast track. But we knew once we were getting closer to the winter season that nothing was going to happen. You know, that's why we tried to fight so hard through the summer. We held a couple of demonstrations down at City Hall. You know, we have to hold our mayor accountable. Everybody says, oh, she just got in office, you need to lay off her a little bit. But, you know, at this point right now, everybody is being held accountable. If you took the position, you have to be held accountable too. And it's, you know, it's a lot of bickering back and forth down there. And at the end of the day, it's always the residents who suffer. You know, it's always the people. You know, the politicians, they do their thing, but at the end of the day, the suffering comes back on us. The struggle comes back on us.
I think one thing that's been lost is, you know, you look at other stories that are getting national attention, North Dakota and other places, that's viewed as a crisis, and it is. But here, after the national cameras left and all the people with pounds of makeup, you know, on their faces, and Obama left with the photo ops, they don't view it as a crisis anymore. But I'm here and I'm seeing it is a crisis.
And not only that, I went to Sandy Rock myself, you know, and I went, when I traveled to Sandy Rock, I wanted to see how the Native Indians were actually doing the difference, you know, just doing the culture difference from them versus to how our that we came together. So when I got out there and I saw the different nationalities, the different religion, it didn't matter if you're what, how much money you made and all of that, and the people joined together. And one of the things that they did, they shut out the media in the beginning, you know, to keep it organized and focused. One thing about Flint, a lot of people in the media, the stars come in, they got starstruck. They forgot about the crisis, like this was some big, you know, they was like, oh my God, I'm getting ready to meet such and such, you know. But hey, wait a minute. When they leave, we still popping bottles. Not bottles of champagne, bottles of water, you know, really. And a lot of our elected leaders, they were starstruck. A lot of them changed. A lot of them took buyouts. You know, a lot of them just were best friends in the beginning, and now they don't even talk to each other. And, you know, when we say our leaders, who are our leaders? You know, the people themselves now have to become the leaders. our everyday citizens, we are the leaders. The people is the leaders. We don't trust the elected politicians no more. Elected leaders, I don't trust Mayor Weaver. You know, I don't trust that her decisions are always for the people. You know, because Governor Snyder tells her what to do. So she's going to go in with Governor Snyder and the RTAB. That's part of Governor Snyder's. You know, so it's still people that's leading our city that still has a great deal with connection with Governor Snyder that's not really letting our people be helped like they should be.
Yeah, it's kind of like, you know, taking your order. If you're a bank, taking your orders from the person who robbed it.
Yes, basically. And, you know, it's just disgusting. It's disgusting. And my mom is 65 years old. Her kneeling went bad since this stuff, and she's limping. And I tell, you know, Governor Snyder, hey, I'm coming for your head. I want you out of office. You know, I know it's election time coming up. No, you need to get out now. You know, I hate that the recall failed, you know, but that still doesn't mean we should have let up. I think we should continue to put pressure on him, to put pressure on him, and to continue to put pressure on him to his last day up in office.
And, I mean, let's be real. This is a predominantly black neighborhood, city, and they're not working, too fast to try to, make things right. Like I said, that would not be the case in a more, you know, wealthy suburban area.
Yeah, and when we sit in on the groups down at the U of M, and they had some people come in, some scientists or whoever came in and talked to some of the community people, and they said that it was like a racial, you know, thing that happened upon us. And to just hear that and then to see and to know that, you know, our community was really targeted, like an experiment, you know, and to just be tested now like lab rats, and we're not animals, you know. Now you want to watch our children. Some of the children haven't even been get the real results from the lead test, you know. Then when you give them the lead test results, there's no follow-up. You know, how do you help that child? How do you get that child the services that they need? You know, so now it's like, let's watch this community and how they pull through this one. You know, like the auto industry. Now that we pulled the auto industry out, let's see how they pull through. You know, we always got to pull through. Flint is a city that's been looked at on a national level. And now, you know, people's like, oh, they're thinking that the water is fixed and things are happening. No, KWA is coming in with its pipeline, you know, and taking our money, you know, just like standing
around. Explain that. What KWA's pipeline?
Yeah, so KWA, when emergency manager sold our pipeline to KWA, which is a new, I don't know the acronym right stuff right now, but they sold this pipeline to them, to the Great Lakes, to where we got to go. It's 9 miles of pipeline that's not even paid for yet. So even if we get this pipeline coming in, we don't have fresh water yet. Because somebody has to still pay for the $9 million that's going to connect us actually to the Great Lakes. So
this is a water pipeline?
Yes, it's a water pipeline. Jeff Wright is part of that, the heads that Mayor Walling was one of the candidates that sat on the committee. Now Mayor Weaver sits on that committee. Eric May sits on that committee. So it's a lot going on with the KWA pipeline that we also as residents have to now come aware that, you know, our water crisis is bigger than just getting our water pipes fixed in Flint. It's even more bigger. It's more like the Standing Rock issue. You know, we have a pipeline that's up towards Canada. What is it called? Enbridge. The Enbridge line.
Enbridge is shadier than all shade.
Right. So now we have to really wake up to the real issues that's happening around in our state. You know, so this crisis, you know, sometimes we have to take it for the good, you know, because it's a wake up call for all of us. You know, not only is 80,000 people being poisoned with lead, if that pipeline at the Enbridge Line 5 break, just think 800,000.
You remember that spill in the Kalamazoo River a few years ago?
Yes.
That was Enbridge.
Right. So you already know. Like, and these are the things that we have to continue to educate our community about, educate our young people about, because they start to be so disconnected, and we got to connect them back to the real issues that's happening.
And lastly, I think something that hasn't been covered, and honestly, I just learned about today, they only when they did test, they only tested for lead and copper. The house I was just in, they found chloroform.
Yes.
And other bacteria.
Yes. Yes. It's a lot more in our water, just the lead and the calcium. We're hearing about all these chemicals. We're hearing about the Legionella bacteria. We're hearing about so much things that's scary, that's sitting at the bottom of our water tank growing, you know. So, and it's, like I said, it's all staying educated. You know, I look at our elected officials now at city council. They don't hold weekly or monthly meetings to educate their ward. You know, you want to say you're the leader for that ward, but where's the education piece that you bring into the residents and let them know about lead, chloroform, not just handing them a sheet of paper, but actually setting up town hall forums where you have it, where you can really, you know, educate the people what they're faced with right now. And so we haven't did that. The mayor didn't do that either. You know, she wanted to do the robocall about the garbage truck fight, you know, the Rizzo and the Republic. We get robocalls to support Rizzo, the company that's corrupt.
How about a robocall? Your water is safe to drink now.
That's what we're saying. So we're out there fighting that. We're out there on city line saying, hey, why we couldn't get a robocall of where all these water pods at? Why we couldn't get a robocall that, you know, our water was not drinkable? Why we couldn't get a robocall, you know? So they pick and choose of what they want to fight with our residents with, and we're saying, you know, we're putting the people first. It's the people over profit. And, you know, we're going to stand up with the veterans and say, hey, this is not, you know, the community is going to come together, and it's basically us against the politicians.
Keep fighting the good fight. Thank you.